only a few days away. So here to make us the perfect bread stuffing with sausage, dried cherries, and pecans from the new Cook's Illustrated Revolutionary Recipes Cookbook, please welcome back the co-host of America's Test Kitchen, one of the best cooks I know, Bridget Lancaster. Welcome back.
Happy to be here.
So I don't know if you saw Ryan's performance, but he got very hungry.
Yeah, I'm hungry.
He's hungry. He's hanging around.
Me today? That makes me very happy.
Yeah, Scotty got hungry just watching.
Yeah, I worked up an appetite.
Also joining us at the counter from A Shoe Addict's Christmas, actor Luke McFarlane. We're so excited to have you as well. We'll speak with you in just a bit about the movie. So I know that you say this is the perfect stuffing.
That's right.
And the key to the perfect stuffing is getting the perfect bread.
Right. Well, it all starts with bread. And we're using plain bread. This isn't cornbread stuffing. So look elsewhere if you want cornbread
stuffing.
Okay, so
no cornbread.
Right. This is plain bread. This is just white sandwich bread. You don't need to use ciabatta or a baguette, anything like that, because it could be a little too tough.
So nothing fancy.
You got that crust on it. You don't need anything fancy. But you also don't want to use something that is super soft, because it'll just turn to mush.
So you want stale bread?
Stale bread, but actually we want toasted bread. Stale bread still has water inside of it.
Oh.
I didn't know that until I read Cook's Illustrated.
Interesting. Okay, so you can take your stale bread, toast it.
Right.
And then we're good to go.
Yeah, just toast it 275 degrees, 250 for about an hour. Okay. You want it to be super dry. And that's a big mistake a lot of people make. They use stale bread. There's moisture hiding inside.
And then it gets mushy.
Right.
And then it's too mushy.
It's too mushy, right.
So we have our stale toasted bread over here. All the moisture is out of it. Over in our skillet, our cast iron skillet, we have browned some turkey wings and legs, I see.
Secret weapon here.
Yeah, tell me about this.
Yeah, so this is 3 pounds of turkey wings. We had them divided at the joint. You can ask your butcher to do that.
Okay.
And we browned them for more flavor. Poked a few holes in the pieces, about 10 holes per piece, so those juices and fats can render out. And that's going to help to flavor this particular stuffing, because, again, we want that turkey flavor to be in every bite.
To make it feel like it was actually cooked inside the turkey.
Exactly.
So we're not cooking them all the way through. We're just browning
them
and then removing them.
That's right. Yep. So these can come out. They were in there for about 4 minutes a side.
And we also browned some turkey sausage over here. I see we've cooked.
Yeah, and that's
set aside.
That is actually plain old pork sausage.
Oh,
you could use turkey sausage if you wanted. But, you know, I like the pig, so I put pork sausage in there.
Listen, we were talking a little bit off camera how important stuffing is to a lot of people, including me, right?
True.
It's my favorite part of Thanksgiving dinner and Christmas dinner, and you did not disappoint. This is out of this world good.
America's Test Kitchen.
Well,
they don't lie.
I shouldn't be surprised.
How many times did you guys test this?
Oh, at least 40 times.
It's crazy.
Where was I for that?
Yeah.
Exactly. You were out handling trees.
Right, exactly.
Yeah, but I'm done. Can I be there for the next test thing?
Sure, You can
definitely
be the taster.
So now
we have all the fat that's been rendered from the turkey.
It's beautiful.
It really is beautiful. And you add your onion and your celery in there.
Exactly. Onion, some celery, finely chopped, because nobody wants big pieces of vegetables in their stuffing. We'd like to forget that there are vegetables in the stuffing altogether.
Right.
And then these go for about 7 minutes. And what we're doing here is we're just getting even more flavor, more browning. And there's some butter in there, too.
Ooh, okay, good, nice.
So we're using the entire farm here.
I love a lot of butter in my stuffing.
So then it turns into this after about 7 minutes. You want to throw that in there
for me?
That is dried. Actually, that's fresh sage. You don't want to use dried sage and dried herbs for Thanksgiving because it's Thanksgiving.
Sure.
So a lot of flavor in the fresh stuff. This fresh sage and the fresh thyme just tastes and it smells a lot better.
Beautiful.
All right, a bit of black pepper.
A little black pepper, okay.
Great.
Thank you.
And you can smell those herbs. Just all at once, it smells like Thanksgiving,
yeah.
right?
Really
That's because
really
those
does.
Herbs really start to bloom in that hot fat. All right, so just a little bit of thank you.
Is that chicken stock or vegetable stock?
That is chicken stock. You could use vegetable stock if you want.
Okay.
And we're just scraping up any of those brown bits on the bottom of the pan. That's flavor.
Right.
You don't want to lose that.
And after we do all that,
I'm coming over to you.
Pour this beautiful medley of onions and celery and spices over our dried bread.
That is a heavy pan. Yep.
Yeah, it
is. There we go. Gorgeous.
And then we add, so I'm going to add a little bit of salt, yeah?
Thank you.
There you go. And then we add something that, this is a first for me. I was really impressed with this. This is not orange juice.
It's not orange juice. That would be kind of a big mistake. Imagine if we did that. Although I could see orange juice and maybe cranberry going together, but not in stuffing. Don't worry. This is a mixture of eggs and chicken stock.
Yeah.
So you're going to get this custardy flavor and texture inside.
And you wouldn't have noticed that,
no.
right?
No. Eggs.
I
know. You're thinking
that.
But that's how it stays together. It clings together. 3 eggs.
Oh, wow.
So it's like breakfast, right?
And then we put that beautiful
the brown sausage
or the turkey sausage, whatever you want.
And this is where you get to play.
Okay, we fluff it together.
Yeah, we've got a couple more additions. We've got dried cherries. You like dried cranberries, dried cranberries. Right. You like dried raisins, blueberries, whatever you want. But a cup is great. You can leave them out, too.
Okay.
We've got another version that's leeks and bacon.
Oh, see, I would like that one. Yeah,
and then a cup of pecans. And you always want to toast the nuts before it goes in. And that's because it really won't toast if it's inside something and you want that deep flavor.
Right. And so when you're putting all the, I was going to say the juice, but the eggs and the broth in there,
that
doesn't make the breadcrumbs too soft?
Like, nope.
In other words, it's the perfect kind of texture, isn't it? Because otherwise they might be too crunchy.
Exactly.
That's why the bread's so important.
That bread is so important.
I'm trying to figure it out as I'm talking.
And drying it out instead of toasting it instead of just leaving stale bread is super important. But look at that amount of stuffing.
That's a lot.
You could never get that all.
I have some of that amount of stuffing. My plate is empty.
True. All right. But
now,
one more.
Now, remember those beautiful wings that we browned?
Mm-hmm.
Here's the real, this is what sends it over the edge. We put those back on top.
They go right on top. And again, remember we browned them and we poked some holes in the turkey wings.
So they're flavoring that stuffing
from
above.
It's all seeping down.
All that juice.
Top-down flavor.
So good.
Top-down flavor, I like that.
There you go.
You know what you're doing over there.
And the good news is, after you take it out, this is more turkey that you can have.
That's right.
But you got to put it in, you got to bake it in the oven?
You bake it for how long?
You bake it for about an hour, hour and a quarter, until it's beautifully browned.
Okay. Covered?
Yep, just with some foil on it. And if you're not sure if your oven is a little too hot, you might want to put a baking dish underneath. I'm going to get the door for you.
Look at this magic.
Now, I'm going to get these off of here. Again, you want to make sure, if you want to put these back in the oven and crisp them up even more, you can do that. But I love turkey wings. It's one of my favorite parts of the turkey. I'm always sad that the turkey only has 2 wings.
Yeah.
So this allows me to eat as many as I want.
Who thought of that?
Should have been 4 wings.
And then you just fluff it up a little bit.
Oh, gosh, look at the steam coming off.
What do you think?
Look,
Bridget,
Debbie can't wait.
Can I dig in there?
As you're serving yourself there, Deb, you can check out the full recipe at HallmarkChannel.com.